Corey Otterdahl.
Corey Otterdahl was an athletic, big guard. I think he played more guard than forward when we were, even though he was probably big enough to be a forward.
Yeah.
He was just such a good ball handler, shooter, guy that he was better on the outside than on the inside.
Good outside shooter, that's kind of
Yeah.
Yeah, he could shoot. What about Dan Nerud?
Dan Nerud, a guy that was big, but when you put him like down low, he was always smaller than the other guy. But he still could do anything he wanted in there. Like, I don't know how he did it. He would rarely get his shot blocked, and he would block a lot of shots on the defensive side. He was just a smart player, a great shot. Right. Like, great touch around the basket.
Yeah, yep, exactly. Jeff MacArthur.
He could jump out of the gym. In fact, I got a... Was it a text from you that was talking about Jeff MacArthur? Somebody texted me and said he's still on the wall at Eden Prairie High School.
Yes, I told you that.
For the state...
Eden Prairie record.
High jump record was Jeff MacArthur.
Yeah.
And that's been a long time ago.
Over 30 years ago, yeah. I think somebody just broke it. But here's a guy who's like 5'11", 6 feet,
yeah,
and had the school record at Eden Prairie high jump. I mean, he could jump out of the gym.
And then he came back to Jefferson after that and finished this senior year when we won state.
Right.
And so he was a guy that was just a smart basketball player. He knew the game, and he could jump. He could rebound like anybody because he could jump so high. But good shooter, good ball handler, kid that hustled.
Okay, so let's get to state tournament. Obviously, hopefully you remember where we played our first round of the state tournament.
It was at the Metrodome.
Yeah. Do you guys know that? Played in the Metrodome, and that was because, right, I think the NCAA was going to have a regional there, like the next year or something, NCAA tournament, and they wanted to test out the dome. And so the state tournament, instead of at Williams Arena, which it would have been, they did it in the Metrodome. So we played our quarterfinal game against Faribault at the Dome. So what do you remember about that game?
I remember just being in the Metrodome was odd, you know, like different.
It's so enormous.
It's so big. And you know, for the high school tournament, you don't get that many people in there that it makes it feel full. You know, it was just you had to get used to shooting on a basket where the perspective is so different.
Right.
You know, everybody that plays high school basketball, you're kind of used to being in the high school gym. And, you know, I'm sure, Kevin, you learned as you playing college basketball, you get in those bigger stadiums, it is tougher to shoot until you get used to it. And we only had warm-ups, really, to get used to it.
Right, right. Now, I played in a couple domes. I played in the Superdome down in New Orleans, and it's like, or the Metrodome, it's like, and that's way even different than, say, like the Civic Center or Williams Arena, you know, where you have to adjust to those places, too. But, like, in a dome, it's like a basket is just hovering. Like it's floating in the air because there's so much space behind it,
right,
that it's really kind of weird to shoot on those things, you know, when you first get in there. So, do you remember much about the game? Any particular plays from that Faribault game?
I just remember it was a close, real close game and being real tired towards the end of the game just because you had been doing a lot of running.
Right.
I think the basketball tournament is one of the, in the format that we did it in, was very tough because you had to play Thursday, and you had to win Thursday, and then you turned right around Friday and you played Friday night, and then you had, you know, turn around and play Saturday night.
Right.
You didn't have any days to rest in between like they do now.
Right. Yeah. That's so we squeaked by. I don't think we played that well against Faribault. We won by two. I don't know if you remember this. Do you remember when we scrimmaged Faribault that season, your senior year? Do you remember that here at Jefferson?
I don't even know if I remember that.
Really? Yeah, we did. And okay. I don't think they probably handled us. It seems like we did a lot of scrimmages against good teams, and we never really played that well in scrimmages. And then we'd
When did we play Mounds View ever?
Every year we scrimmage Mounds View.
We would scrimmage them. And did we ever see them in this? Was it maybe the year before in the state tournament? Or
no, they in 86, your senior year, Mounds View made the state. They had a good team that year. They were good enough to win it all, I think. And so, yeah, they played the game right before us, right before our Faribault game.
I see.
Mounds View played St. Paul Central. And they lost a real close game, yeah. So we could have played Mounds View. And like I said, they were pretty tough. And we scrimmaged Mounds View that year, too, in 86 at some point. And I remember we go up to Mounds View to scrimmage. And it's like they didn't – it was December or January. And it was like an icebox.
I remember that.
In that gym. It was
funny,
so cold.
The first thing that came to my mind was it was cold before you even said that. So I remember that.
You see your breath in the gym. It's like, dude, don't they have heaters around here? Turn the heat on. Come on, this is ridiculous. Okay, so we get by Faribault when we get to St. Paul Central. I think they were either undefeated or one loss that year. So we got them in the semifinals at the Civic Center. Any thoughts on that game?
Well, I remember being nervous about that game because we just didn't know a whole lot about them other than they had one loss or they were undefeated, whatever. You know, I knew
right,
that.
Right.
And so I thought it was going to be a real tough game, you know. And I mean, what we ended up winning by a lot, I think.
Beating by 25.
25, okay. And we were up maybe even more than that for, you know, they came back towards the end, I think. But I remember, after the first quarter, it was almost like the game was just about over at the end of the first quarter. But we had shot the ball. They helped us out by missing a lot of shots, and we'd get the rebounds and come down and score every single time. I don't remember details in that game. I just remember we handled them very easily.
We jumped on them, and they didn't play well. We were playing well, and we jumped on them, got like a 10-point lead really quick, and they just never showed up. You know, that's right. Kind of my memory. And they were a good team, and they had talent, and they did not handle our zone very well. You know, they just did not make outside shots, and they were in trouble from the very beginning, and we just climbed on them and beat them by 25. And that's a good team. They just did not play very well. But we played well that game.
Right.
So.
And we did, I think we did a good job of, most of our defense was zone.
Right.
And we played so much zone that we got really good at it. You know, and like I said, there wasn't a three-point line when we were playing.
Right.
So it was a little bit easier to box everything up into a 2-3 zone.
Just pack it in.
Force people to shoot from the outside because it was only 2 points.
Right.
And if they're going to miss more than 50% of the time, well, we're probably going to get the rebound.
Right.
So.
Okay, so we get by Central, get into Duluth Central in the state championship game the next night. I don't know if you remember this about Duluth Central. They were undefeated coming into that state championship game. They're ranked number one in the state. Their coach, Jim Hastings, was retiring that night. I don't know if you remember that.
Yeah, no.
After coaching for like 30 years or 35 years or whatever, he was retiring after that game. And we had scrimmaged Duluth Central over Christmas time that season. So 3 months before we played them for the title, we went up to Duluth Central. Do you remember that?
I do remember that.
And they clobbered us.
And I remember how that was kind of a physical scrimmage. They were a pretty physical team. Like their guards were big, strong guys.
Right.
And I remember that it was a battle. I remember playing up there because Coach Evans was from Superior, and it was interesting to hear him. When we were up there, I remember him talking about, you know, games at Superior that he played in and when he was in high school. And it was just kind of neat to learn things about your coach.
Right, exactly. So we scrimmaged them. We see him in the state championship game 3 months later. I mean, that was the first time I watched that game in probably 20 years. It was just like in the last year. And we brought in Tim Radosovich and Dan Sunneberg just a week ago, interviewed those guys that played on that Central team. And I had forgotten until I rewatched that game how hard fought and hotly contested that game was. That was a great game. I don't think it was well played in some ways, but it was two teams going at it. I mean, is that kind of your memory of that game?
Oh yeah, that was like a not a battle but a war. It was for me. I remember how tired I was after, you know, now you're into your third day of playing in a row and pretty much playing just about every minute.
Yeah.
You know, and the legs start to go and you're tired.
That's one thing I noticed from that game too when I rewatched it was how many balls you tipped in that game, and I've forgotten how well and how hard you had played in that game. I mean, you were all over the place. Is that kind of your memory?
I think that, you know, it's one of those, you watch the state tournament as a kid every year and you make it to the finals. I just remember, you know, I'm going to do whatever I can to win this game, you know? And so I'm sure everybody's given their all, but I didn't want to lose, you know?
And then Walker makes the key free throws at the
end. He did.
That was so clutch, and we win by a point. All right, Jeff, I'm going to just kind of throw a few things at you, and you just tell me what comes to mind when I say this stuff. Do you think there was an aura, or is an aura, or was an aura around Jefferson basketball, an aura?
For some reason, all of the teams, when we were, that I could remember, won a lot of games. You know, and I don't know if it was just the really good coaching, because I know we got really good coaching. And you know, I've thought about it over the years, and it was the things that they said and taught, but also kind of the manner in how they did it that helped you be relaxed, but yet you wanted to win for them. And they were comfortable enough with what they had to say to you, to tell you, you know, good, bad, ugly things, but do it in a way that still you had a lot of respect for them. And so, you know, I'm sure those coaches would tell you that they were fortunate to have a lot of good athletes. Like you were saying before, when we had all those Division I and Division II and III guys that, right, you know, went on to play different places. And yeah, you know, good athletes help. But it takes somebody to pull them together, too, and get them all on the same page.
Right.
So I think it's a combination of having a lot of good athletes and getting a lot of good coaches. Even in our youth programs, we had good youth coaches helping us get better and learn.
Exactly. I can't agree more. How about, what do you remember about practice and how well prepared we were? And that has to do with the coaching too.
Oh yeah, I think, like I said, you know, in some ways maybe it was a little easier then because we didn't have a three-point line. And we learned how to play that zone defense. and you know, once in a while we'd go to man-to-man, but we'd always go back to that zone because we knew it so well, and we knew, you know, how to help sag off in the middle and help guys down low. And sometimes if they're shooting better from the outside, we'd move out on them, and the guys down low would learn how to move up and get in front of the big guys. So it's just some of that is just the repetition of practicing doing those things over and over and over again, doing them the right way until you get so good at it that, you know,
right,
you're just going to do the right thing when you're in the crunch time, you know?
Right. I mean, that's coaching, right? And that's what you're talking about. That's their job to get us ready to play. All right. How about in today's environment, you have kids that are in high school and played high school sports. I mean, it's like, kids move around, open enrollment, kids at different schools, and all this movement of kids. And Jeff and Jack have done a great job, I think, of just kind of like the commitment to the community, like the kids here. Jefferson would win or lose with kids from this area, you know, and that's for sure how Jack was when we were playing. But just talk about Jack and Jake and Jeff's commitment to the community and the Jefferson kids.
Yeah, I think that, they had that attitude that they were going to, you know, they didn't have to go out and recruit anybody because they had a lot of good athletes here. You know, it was just a matter of picking and choosing the right ones. and putting them in the right role. And that's, I think, you know, for me, Coach Evans and Coach Lynch, they could key in on a guy and figure out what his weaknesses were and then work on that from the beginning of practice, from the beginning of the season, all the way through till the end of the year. And by the end of the year, that guy didn't have so many weaknesses anymore. You know, like, you know, he had improved. And you take that with each player, and pretty soon that team's pretty good.
You know? Playing together, too.
Yeah.
Okay, next one is success. The success of the program. You know, from 1970, I've said this so many times now, these guys, their heads are spinning. From 1975 to 1987, those 12 years, Jefferson basketball team, boys basketball team, made it to 7 state tournaments, 4 state championships, a third place finish, and a consolation finish, all in the stretch of 12 years. Playing in the toughest conference in the state, coming out of the toughest section in the state. So that run, we were kind of right at the tail end of it, basically. But just talk about the success of the boys' program here with basketball.
Yeah, I'm proud to say that, you know, I'm a graduate of Jefferson High School, and the things, you know, as you get older, like I'm older now, you learn that, you know, things they were teaching you help you in life more than they did in athletics.
Right.
But the things that they, you know, that they were just teaching you athletic stuff to help you get better and how to work and how to, you know, be a good teammate. And those things have stuck with me the rest of my life. I'm very proud to have played for the coaches that I did.
Right. Oh, for sure. Last one here, Munce. And that's kind of what you're talking about, the team, you know, being a good teammate, but just family, togetherness, teamwork.
Yeah.
That's Jefferson Hoops right there.
For sure. And I think that they did such a good job in the youth programs. Like we were discussing before how, like, I didn't know how good the kids in your class were, because all we ever played was our grade. And until you started to, like, junior, senior year, that's about the first year that you even mix with another class, you know? And at the time, they had enough athletes where they didn't need to go down to get
eighth graders.
Yeah. You know, they had enough guys that were good. And I'm sure that they'd be the first ones to tell you they were lucky because of that, you know.
Right. No, that's a big part of it. Is now you got ninth graders getting pulled up. And that's so true, and that's so different. Is my sophomore year, your junior year, was the first time I ever played with you guys.
Right.
And that's the first time you probably played with the 85 guys. You just didn't mix because the classes were so big and you had so many good athletes and talent, you didn't need to pull kids up.
Right.
You know?
And I think there wasn't this feeling of, like, if I'm not going to play varsity basketball as a 10th grader or an 11th grader, maybe I should just quit. You know, like, that never even crossed my mind. You know, it made it easier when there wasn't kids moving up and everybody was in, you just played with your class. You know, the sophomore team played with all sophomores, pretty much. And
that's a good thing.
Oh, yeah, that was a good thing. I mean, it's just the way it was.
Yeah, Jack and Jake were awarded seniors. That's how they did it. So I think that's...